Welcome back students to the next chapter, current electricity. In the previous chapters of electrostatics, we have learned about static electricity. In this chapter, we are going to learn about current electricity. In this module, we will be discussing about electric current, Ohm's law and resistivity. Initially, you must understand what is electric current. We know electric current is the rate of flow of electrons in a conductor. The SI unit of electric current is ampere. So we usually say rate of charge flow is called current, represented by capital I, and capital I is equivalent to delta Q by T, where delta Q is the amount of charge flowing in an interval of T second, and 1 ampere is equivalent to 1 coulomb per second, where coulomb is the unit of charge and second is the unit of time. Ampere is represented by capital A. In the case of conductors, we know for a current flow, there must be a potential difference across it. And current always flows from high potential to low potential. When a battery is connected across the ends of a conductor, surface charges of opposite sign build up on the conductor starting from the two ends in contact with the battery terminals. You can see the direction of electric field which is formed inside the conductor. We have already studied Ohm's law in class 10, according to which under constant temperature, the electric potential is directly proportional to current, or V is proportional to I. If you are removing the proportionality sign, you can introduce a constant R, where R is known as the resistance of the conductor. Unit of electric potential is volts. Current is ampere and resistance is ohms. The representation of ampere, volt and ohm can be got from the figure. This diagram gives you a brief explanation of Ohm's law. Whenever current tries to flow, the resistance ohm is trying to block it, whereas the potential difference volt is trying to push the current or make the current flow. This triangle gives you an idea about Ohm's law. You can see V, I and R inside the triangles. From the triangle, we can write V is equivalent to IR, or I is equivalent to V by R, or R is equivalent to V by I. You can remember the equations easily from this Ohm's law triangle. We know the unit of V is volts, or potential difference is volts, current is amperes, and resistance is ohms. If you are plotting a graph between electric current and voltage, according to Ohm's law, we can see that V will be always proportional to I, and it will be a straight line having a constant slope. coming to the concept of resistivity, the resistance of a wire is always found to be directly proportional to the length of the wire and inversely proportional to the area of cross section A. So you can write R is proportional to L by A. If you are removing the proportionality sign, you must introduce a constant. This constant is known as rho, which is the resistivity, which is a characteristic of the material. Hence, R is equivalent to rho L by A, where R is the resistance, rho is the resistivity, L is the length of the conductor, and A is the area of cross section. So, at a fixed temperature, the amount of resistance offered in the flow of current by a conductor having unit length and unit cross section is called its specific resistance. Specific resistance is the other name for resistivity. The unit of specific resistance is ohm meter. Specific resistance of a conductor depends on the material of the conductor and its temperature. Next, you have to study about a term called current density. Current density J is defined as the current per unit area, or J is equivalent to I by A, where I is the amount of current flowing through a conductor having an area of cross section A. Let us discuss about the electric field inside a current carrying conductor. Let the current carrying conductor be of length L and area of cross section A, having a resistance R with a potential difference delta V across it. We know R is equivalent to rho L by A and I is equivalent to J into A, and V is equivalent to E into L. We have studied V is equivalent to E into D in the previous chapter. Also, from Ohm's law, V is equivalent to IR. Then, equating the terms for delta V, we get E into L is equivalent to IR. Substituting for I as J into A and R as rho into L by A, we get E into L is equivalent to J into rho into L. Cancelling L on both sides, we get E is equivalent to J rho. That is, electric field is equivalent to current density into resistivity. Or we can say J is equivalent to E by rho. 1 by rho is known as conductivity sigma. Hence, substituting sigma is equivalent to 1 by rho, we get J is equivalent to sigma E, where sigma is the conductivity of the material. Hope you have understood about Ohm's law, resistivity and current density. Thank you, dear students.